Now I'm telling you again, you just match it. Robert Hooke with Cork cell, Schleiden and Schwann with the cell theory, yeast with unicellular, muscle cells are spindle shaped, red blood cells are biconcave, nerve cells are elongated.
Yes, I'm correct.
Fine. Okay, now let's move to the next part. That is what you can see the cell. That is, I'm speaking very slow. Still. It's fine. Oh, it's okay. Now it's clear. It will be clear only. Okay, fine. So now the basic structure we will be studied means the every cell must be having cell membrane, cytoplasm and nucleus. So these part of the cell you will find in every cell. You can see in the plant cell, you can see these parts in the animal cell. And this cytoplasm and the nucleus together they known as protoplasm. PROTOPLASM plasm. So the living content, this is the cytoplasm and the nucleus, this is the living content of the cell and that is known as protoplasm. So thin membrane that surrounds the cell, that is known as cell membrane, and that encloses the cytoplasm and nucleus, that is the living content, and that is known as protoplasm. So when we say protoplasm, that means we are talking for both cytoplasm, that is the jelly-like structure present in the cell, and the nucleus, that is the control center of the cell, that control all the activities, all the life processes, all the vital processes of the cell. So protoplasm is the living content of the cell. Protoplasm is actually made up of, whenever we say protoplasm, that means we are talking about a jelly-like substance which is present inside the cell, in which the all cell organelles are embedded. Cell organelles means the small or the tiny structures present inside the cell. Cell itself a very tiny structure, but inside the tiny structure, means inside the cell, few more tiny structures are there. They are called cell organelles, and they do the different life processes, they do the different function for the cell. So cytoplasm is the jelly like substance, and in which the all the cell organelles are embedded. So many specialized structures, so the tiny structures present in the cell along with the cytoplasm and nucleus, those small structures which are present in the inside the cell and that performs the different function for the cell are known as cell organelle. Cell organelle, CELLORGANELLES. So cell organelles. So this is the basic structure. Though when we talk about prokaryote and eukaryote, prokaryote and eukaryote means prokaryotic cells are the cells in which the nucleus is not prominent. So in that the cell organelles are not present, but ribosome is present and the prokaryotes also. But in eukaryotic cells, all the cell organelles are present. Mostly means in plant and animal, there is a difference of few cell organelles. Like in plant cell, chloroplast, green chlorophyll is stored in the chloroplast. But that chlorophyll is absent in the animal, so chloroplast is absent in the, or plastids are absent in the animals. So there are some changes, some are differences between the plant and animal cell, but the basic structure is same only. So now let's start cell membrane. Cell membrane is actually the outermost membrane which bound the all the content of the cell. Here I will show you the picture. Like here, this is the outermost layer, this one. This is the cell membrane. This that bounds all internal structure of the cell. It's a living and elastic in nature. Means this is this is not tough, this is not hard, it's elastic. Flexible, you can say. It's having pores. So that the substance can move in and out. Means these membranes are having the small pores. So because every cell need nutrient as well as oxygen, so that has to reach inside. For that, this wall is having a small pore so that the substance can transport in and out. So this is living. How many points for the cell membrane? This is a living part of the cell. This is elastic in nature, elastic or you can say flexible, and it has small pores, fine pores, and that is means selectively permeable. They means capable to what you can say, allow some substances to pass through but not others. Means they have capability to select the substances. Means they by default they know that which substance is needed for the cell, so they allow to enter inside the cell, and which substances are supposed to go out from the cell. So they know they are selectively permeable, they capable to select, so they allow the substances to go out, some of the substances to go out from the cell, and some of the substances to to enter in the cell. By default they know, means the cell membrane know, or what you can say, that's why the name is given to the cell membrane is selectively permeable. Means it can select substances which are needed for the cell and which are needed to excrete or to go out from the cell. So how many points are there for the cell membrane? It's living, it's elastic or flexible, it's having pores, and the most important, it's selectively permeable. Means it's not allow all the substance to go inside the cell or all the substances to go out of the cell. So it allow only few of the substances which are needed for the survival of the cell, for the functioning of the cell, and as a result of the metabolic activity, some excretory substances are formed inside the cell that has to be removed from it, and some substances which are formed in the cell, they need to be transported to the nearby cell, so they has to be transported to the another cell. So this cell membrane by default, it knows that which substance has to go out or which is needed to be entered in the cell. So now you just raise your hand and tell me, yes, who is this Saba Ali? Saba Ali. I don't know. This is the student's name. Saba Ali. Faizan, you tell me. Faizan. Faizan, you tell me few points for the cell membrane. You tell me the point. Yes, that point which I told just now for the cell membrane. Tell me, what is the point I told you?
Cell membrane.
Yes, Ahmed Ali Abdullah, now on mute. Yes.
Yes, ma'am. When the cells elastic
means flexible. Okay. Cell membrane is living, elastic in nature, and it's having pores, fine pores, small pores to exchange the substances in and out, and selectively permeable. Yes, what are you asking? What?
In page number 4, ma'am, in page number 4, there is a,
page number 40, page number 40, what do you ask?
Ma'am, in 440 and
41, what? Cytoplasm. Cytoplasm only, I told you that it's a jelly-like substance present in the cell, in which the other cell organelles are embedded. It's a jelly-like substance inside the cell where all the cell organelles are embedded. Cytoplasm. Okay, now.